Hello, I'm Dr. Carol. This is Dr. Meg. Welcome back to our channel. And today we want to talk to you a bit about children and something that's pretty common, which we see quite often in our office, and it's ear infections. Ear pain is the number one reason that children go to their pediatrician. And it's estimated that 62% of American children will have an ear infection before they're 1 year old and 80% before they're 3 years old. So it's really quite an epidemic. The cost of the treatment and the visits to the pediatrician is estimated at $3 billion a year. It's incredible. And typically what happens is these kids, and we've seen this a lot in our practice, that they'll have been on multiple rounds of different antibiotics, because they do a course of antibiotics, it doesn't work, they do another course of antibiotics, it doesn't work. It's just like this wheel of continuing down the rabbit hole of antibiotics that aren't working. And usually at the end of 3 or 4 or 5 attempts at antibiotics, they do ear tube surgery. That's a very typical course for children in America with ear infections. So it's important to understand that there's alternatives, and that doesn't have to be the course that your child or a child that you know of who suffers from ear infections that they go through. And the number one reason that children come to chiropractors is because of ear pain.
One of the things we find when we check children right after birth is a subluxation, which is the neurology piece that we check for, the interruption in the brain's pathway through the spinal cord. And one of the things that we find all the time on newborns is a subluxation or a misalignment, an irritation in the top bone in their neck, the top bone right underneath their very pliable cranium that just hopefully came through the vaginal canal. And that is the number one subluxation that we see. And when that's happening, it means that the functionality of the brain stem and that area of the brain isn't working properly. And it's also an interruption to all flow. So it's the interruption to the fluid flow through that area. And the children's eustachian tube grows as they grow so quickly in that first year of life, but it's at an angle where fluids and irritations, if they're not draining properly due to an irritated nervous system, can become congested. So that's absolutely, a child doesn't leave here without us checking that right away. We also check the bones of their head. Their head is very pliable. They're called cranial bones, and there's space between all of them. As you know, babies have those little soft spots that are open, but all of them are open. And as the baby's growing and they come through the canal, it's very often, especially if their birth has been
challenging,
yes, that's the word. If that has happened, their cranium can be misshapen. And therefore, again, this beautiful brain that's in there growing them minute by minute as a child and having their immune system be constantly challenged, it's in a case that's not right. And when that happens, the flow isn't right. So again, those are two places that a chiropractor checks absolutely on every child that we see moments after birth or as soon as we can meet them.
What the adjustments do is they help to improve and restore proper blood flow, proper lymph drainage, which is critical with ear infections and immune system function, and it allows for the child to heal. There was a study done in the Journal of Chiropractic Pediatrics, and they found that 80% of the children in the study did not have any reoccurring ear infections within the six months after they started chiropractic care, which is, if you compare that to the typical child that's going to their pediatrician, it's radically different. It's really a safe, effective tool that parents can utilize to allow their kids to recover from ear infections. And I don't know, over the 30 years that we've been in practice, there have been hundreds of kids that we have dealt with that have ear infections. One, I remember, it was a child that had a double ear infection. It was, I think, her third. I don't even think she was 2 years old. And her mother was at her wit's end, and she was scheduled for ear tube surgery the next week. And she had one adjustment, and they brought her to the pediatrician. They were like, she doesn't need any ear tubes anymore. So And that's, I mean, we could tell dozens of those kinds of stories, and it just really goes to show how effective it is when you get the spine clear, the nervous system functioning, and the body can do its job of healing.
One of the reasons for those tubes is to put a puncture hole through the drum so it can drain. Wouldn't it be great, though, if we could open up the tube to the drum to allow it to open and drain? It seems so, it makes so much sense. Lastly, I want to point out is that if a mama can nurse the baby, and nursing from both sides is really critical for how the body, the baby's body, develops tone around the inner ear. Oftentimes, I have adjusted babies while they're nursing so that I can actually get that movement while we're adjusting. So nursing is great. That milk is all about antibodies, which is immunity, so that's a really smart thing to do. And then know that if you use other things, like formulas, they are high in sugar, and that sugar irritates the immune system in the inner ear. So be cognizant of that, that that's an irritant where you would definitely need to make sure that baby stays strong and healthy. I also, we have found oftentimes as the baby grows that during times of teething, their pH, which is the amount of acidity and alkalinity from their mouth to their whole canal, it's called the alimentary canal, all the way down to where they lose their stool, their bottom, all of that changes so that the teeth can come through the hard bone and come through the tissue. So when that pH changes and the flora and natural immunity in the mouth changes, it's a really prime time to have irritation there too. So it's another time when if you notice your baby's drooling, if you notice your baby's irritable, things like this are sort of signs that they have rashes in their mouth or by their bottom. These are signs that their body's physiology is changing, and it is time and absolutely a perfect time to get them adjusted so that they can prevent these ear situations that we're talking about. See you soon.